We're now being joined on Newstrack by security and conflict analyst Ndu Wokolo in our Abuja studio. Well, thank you for joining us on Newstrack.
Thank you.
Well, the defense spokesman reeled out some of the challenges they face in the theater of war, and one of them concerns intelligence. So the question is, why is it difficult for the military to get intelligence information, especially from the locals, to aid the fight against insurgents?
I quickly remember a book written by Oliver Kaplan from the research he did in Colombia, Pakistan, and Afghanistan, where he said that communities have a way of dealing with such insurgency. And they can only do that when they buy into what you're doing, when they think you can protect them, when they think that the information they give to you will not come back to bite them. So if they are unable to get those kind of assurance, you are not likely to get that cooperation from them. I think that is what is happening in Boronu. The people have not really bought into what the government is doing. They are not sure if they give the information, the government has the capacity to protect them. So why would they want to risk their life? Boko Haram or the insurgents on the other side are trying to equally be smart. And that's why you can see the kind of killing they've just done. It's just like a warning. If you do this, we'll come back for you. So between the people are almost like between the heartless, you know, and what is happening. They can only comply, give you that intelligence, one, when they think the government has the capacity to protect them. Two, when they think that giving government that information will help government to win the war. So government really need to do a lot. There is something fundamentally wrong that we are doing. Until we're able to get those things right, the people will not cooperate.
I mean, the irony of this is the fact that the government, the military says, I mean, they're there to protect the people. So you wonder why we still have those discrepancies. But I'd like you to also speak to insinuations out there that, you know, maybe the farmers did not get security clearance before going on the field to farm. What do you make of that?
First, what has happened, but it shows that there's a lack of coordination, there's a lack of synergy, there's a lack of accountability. We are doing some things, and I think we are getting it fundamentally wrong. You know, if you look at what is happening, it seems Boko Haram or the insurgency in the country is moving towards a particular direction, targeting the food security of the country. It's happening in Boronu, another part of the northeast, is equally happening in the northwest, and is equally happening in the north central. I got a call from one of my colleagues in Niger State telling me that these days women cannot even go to farm because they will come with trailers and not just pack all of them, kidnap all of them. So there's this target on our food security situation. So did the farmers get the clearance to go and harvest their farm or do their planting? If you look at what the governor had just said, he said, if you don't go, you might actually die of hunger. So it's almost like people trying to find a way to get out of a very difficult situation. And what I'm thinking is that clearance or no clearance, if we have a security architecture that we have designed for these farmers, to have them protected, especially during planting and harvesting season, we should be getting a very good result. So I think there's a lack of accountability and the synergy in the entire operational safe corridor program that we are operating in Boronu.
I mean, and we've seen the result of that. Food prices skyrocketing, and I mean, you mentioned the food crisis, but I'd like to also take you up on this. Do you suspect, because there have been talks yet again, especially from the government side, so do you suspect the likelihood of international conspiracy in all these attacks?
No, I would not directly say that. However, today's world, insurgency like terrorism is not something you can say these days. To actually say that a particular terror attack is just local, is to be almost economical with truth. You can find out that Boko Haram is currently or is being funded by other organizations not from Nigeria. So yes, it could have an international perspective, but to link a state to it, I'm not too sure. But nothing is. You can't rule out anything in these days. You cannot rule out anything.
Well, Mr. Ndu Nwokolo, would like to thank you so much for sharing your thoughts with us on NewsTrack.
Thank you.